In this lesson, we will learn about the relation between division and multiplication. One day, Chanda found three shiny pouches right outside her house. Chanda first opened one pouch and found some pumpkin seeds in it. Very next day, she sowed those seeds. Within a few days, 15 huge pumpkins grew. Chanda was not able to believe her eyes. She had never seen a pumpkin of this size in her entire life. Chanda decided to divide the 15 large pumpkins among her five friends equally. Children, can you tell how Chanda will do this? Chanda first gave two pumpkins each to her five friends. Then she will give one more pumpkin. How many pumpkins will Chanda give to each friend? Three pumpkins. How can we write this by using division? When you divide 15 pumpkins equally in five parts, you get three pumpkins in each part. If we look closely, we will see that we have five friends, and each friend will get three pumpkins. How else can we write this? Absolutely correct. We can write it like this by using multiplication. 5 multiplied by 3 is 15 pumpkins. Children, we can write any division in the form of multiplication. Now, Chanda opened her second parcel. She found some rice grains in it. Chanda thought that she could cook some kheer for herself. But as soon as she began cooking the kheer, it kept on increasing and increasing in quantity. At last, from those rice grains, Chanda managed to make 48 kg of kheer. Chanda needed to divide that kheer among 12 people in the village. Can you tell how much kheer each villager would get? Chanda will first give 2 kg of kheer to each individual. Then she will give 1 kg more kheer to each of them. And finally, 1 more kg of kheer. This way, Chanda will divide 48 kg kheer equally among 12 people, and each person will receive 4 kg of kheer. How can we write this by using division? Absolutely correct. We can write it like this using division. Children, can you write this division in the form of multiplication? If you like, you can pause the video and find the answer. Very good, children. You have found the right answer. If there are 12 people and each person gets 4 kg of kheer, then total quantity of kheer is 48 kg. 12 multiplied by 4 is 48. We can write this multiplication in one more way. If every person gets 4 kg kheer and there are 12 people who get kheer, then total quantity of kheer is 4 multiplied by 12, which is 48 kg. We can write any division in two ways in terms of multiplication. Just when Chanda was about to open the third pouch, she remembered the happiness she had felt after opening the first two pouches. She thought, why not give this pouch to her friend Babban and make him happy? Thinking this, Chanda quietly left the pouch outside Babban's door. Now, what did Babban find in that pouch? This you will find out in the next video. Children, in this video, we learned about the relation between division and multiplication. In the next video, we will bring to you some interesting examples related to this. Hello, children. In the previous video, we learned about the relation between division and multiplication. In this video, you will see some interesting examples related to this. In the last video, we saw how Chanda had quietly left her third pouch outside Babban's door. When Babban spotted that pouch, he picked it up and got it inside the house. When Babban opened the pouch, he found some wooden sticks in it. Babban kept those sticks in one of the corners of his bedroom and slept. Next morning, when he woke up, he saw that those sticks had overnight turned into a large pile of sticks. There were 48 wooden sticks in total. He thought that he would divide these equally among his 6 friends. Can you tell how many sticks will each friend get? To begin with, we can give 4 wooden sticks to each one of his friends like this. We can then further give them 3 sticks each. And finally, we can give 1 stick more to each friend. This way, we can make bundles of 8 sticks to divide 48 sticks equally among 6 friends. How can we write this in the form of multiplication? Absolutely correct. We can write it in terms of multiplication like this. If there are 6 friends and each friend is given 8 sticks, then total number of sticks will be 48. Or if each friend is given 8 sticks and the number of friends is 6, then the total number of sticks will be 48. Children, can we use multiplication to answer a question on division? Yes, look at the division and multiplication here. Can you spot some similarities in these two? Oh yes, if we need to find out the answer for division question, all we need to do is look up the table of 6 and see what multiplied by 6 is 48. Or in the table of 8, what multiplied by 8 equals 48. So children, in the table of 6, what do we multiply with 8 to get 48? Absolutely correct. 6 times 8 is 48. And in the table of 8, what times 8 equals 48? Correct again. 8 times 6 equals 48. In this way, we can use multiplication to figure out the answer for division. For example, 8 sticks per friend or 6 friends, it can be found out. As Babban had thought, he gave 8 sticks to his friend Golu Panda. Golu decided to share those 8 sticks equally with 4 friends. How many sticks will Golu give to each of his friends? Children, can you use multiplication to find the answer to this question? If you want, you can pause the video here to think of the answer. Excellent! Your answer is absolutely correct. We need to look at the table of 4 and look up the place where 8 appears. 4 times 2 is 8. So, the answer to this part is 2. Total number of sticks is 8. To be divided among 4 friends, each friend will get 2 sticks. Golu divided the wooden sticks among his friends, and this made them very, very happy. Children, follow their example and share what you have with your friends and stay happily together. Children, in this video, we saw some interesting examples related to multiplication and division. Hello children, in the previous video, we saw some interesting examples related to multiplication and division. In this video, we will see some misconceptions around these concepts. Raju and Bablu are out in the market. Raju read what was written on Gaggu's shop front. 4 pencils for 20 rupees. He asked Bablu, how much would they have to pay if they wanted to buy 1 pencil? Children, Can you tell how much Raju and Bablu would need to pay for one pencil? Oh yes, Raju and Bablu will need to pay 5 rupees for one pencil. We can find this answer with division like this. Children, how can we write this in terms of multiplication? Absolutely correct. This is the way in which we can write it in terms of multiplication. 4 pencils and each pencil costs 5 rupees. So, the total is 20 rupees. Bablu quickly handed 5 rupees to Gaggu and bought the pencil. Raju was amazed at how fast Bablu had calculated the answer. Then Bablu wrote these division and multiplication equations for Raju. He told Raju that he found the answer for division by using multiplication. Raju got excited when he heard about the relation between division and multiplication. Raju said to Bablu that he can write this multiplication like this also. 5 rupees per pencil and 4 pencils, so the total amount is 20 rupees. Children, has Raju written it correctly? Yes, he has. Raju has written this correctly. We can write any kind of multiplication in two ways. Then Raju thought that he can also write division in two ways because of the relation between division and multiplication. Therefore, after writing division like this, he happily told Bablu that he had become an expert in maths. Children, is the division written by Raju correct? No, what Raju has written is wrong. But why is it wrong? Because here Raju is dividing 4 pencils in 20 rupees. And is this even possible? Not at all. This is not possible. Bablu laughed and explained to Raju that even though division and multiplication have a relationship, the way we do for multiplication, we cannot write division sums by changing places of numbers. Raju took Bablu's pencil from him and said that with that pencil, he would practice his math skills and become an expert at it. Both of them burst out laughing. Children, in this video, we saw some misconceptions about relationship between multiplication and division.